Hey guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So, a very happy Republic Day in advance to you all. And this video is definitely going to help you in your examinations like RBI, SEBI, NABARD. So, let's begin this video without any delay. But before that, those who are coming for the first time, guys, subscribe and hit this bell notification. And also, you can join this Telegram group where we provide free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. Okay. So here we are on our first question, which is about an MOU in the field of solar energy. So the first question is, with which country has India recently signed an MOU to identify research demonstration pilot projects in areas such as photovoltaic storage technologies and technology transfer? So basically the purpose of this MOU is the collaboration in the field of solar energy. Now, with which country has this MOU been signed by India? So we have France, Netherlands, Israel, Uzbekistan and Denmark in the options. What is the right answer? The right answer is option D, Uzbekistan. So that's all for this question. But my question from you is that recently, basically in the recent months, a line of credit has been given by India to Uzbekistan. Now your question is that you have to tell me the amount of the line of credit that was given to Uzbekistan for development projects. So that's your question, first question I would say of this day. Okay, so the next question is, with which state has Power Grid signed an agreement for improving the telecom connectivity of the state by using optical ground wire telecom network? So guys, basically under this MOU, the telecom connectivity in the rural areas of the state will be improved, and you will get to know the importance of this MOU in a little later when you know the answer of this question. So let's discuss the answer of this question first. So you have Himachal Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Goa, Tamil Nadu in the options. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option A, Himachal Pradesh. Now you would know that in the hilly areas, especially hilly and remote areas, the telecom connectivity is very low, and therefore in order to increase that connectivity, this MOU has been signed by Power Grid and Himachal Pradesh government. That's all for this question. And I would like to ask you a question regarding Himachal Pradesh. Guys, do you know how many national parks are there in Himachal Pradesh? If you know, then name the national parks in the comment section below. Okay, so the next question is about an index, which is a very important index. Let me warn you in the beginning itself. So do listen to me very carefully. Okay. How many parameters are used in the military strength ranking 2021, which is released by Global Firepower? So this, if you guys are following Spotlight magazine regularly, then you would have definitely come across this ranking released by the Global Firepower. So what is the purpose of this ranking? This ranking assesses the military strength of different countries and gives them the power index score. So on the basis of that score, the ranking is given. Now, how many parameters are used to assess the countries? So we have 100, 60, 50, 70, 80 in the options, and out of these, the right answer is 50. Total 50 parameters are used to adjudicate a total number of 138 countries. So we have discussed three important parts of this index. First, the organization which releases this index. Second, the number of parameters. And third, the number of countries. Now, fourth and fifth parts are the top country and India's rank. So let's discover that. Here you can see first rank is United States. It's a very obvious thing. I don't think you have to do any kind of extra work to remember this, that US has the largest and the strongest military in the world. Then we have Russia, then we have China at the third place, and India is at the fourth place. So fifth is occupied by Japan. Now the things that you have to remember are, first is US score and second is India's score. Now you would be thinking that India's score is higher than US, then why is the ranking is like this? The reason behind this is this score is considered as the perfect score in this index, and it is practically impossible to attain this score according to the global firepower that releases this index. Therefore, despite having the higher ranking than US, India is at the fourth position. Now, which country is at the bottom? It's the happiest country in the world, that is Bhutan. So it has the lowest, or we would say weak, military in the world. It has been ranked at the 138th position. Next question is related to a bank. So which bank has launched Aura credit card? So there are not many facts related to this question. It's a very basic and simple question. A credit card has been launched. Which bank has launched it? So therefore, from this question, you should keep this thing in your mind that such kind of credit cards or the new partnerships that banks form are important and can be asked in the examination. So do not dare, I would say, do not dare to ignore those news. Now, as far as this question is concerned, the answer is option A, Axis Bank. Now, this Aura credit card has a speciality, and that is it provides special benefits in the field of health and wellness. And apart from this, Axis Bank has partnered with this company to offer the benefits under this credit card. Now, my question from you, you have to tell me the tagline of Axis Bank along with the MD of the bank. So these are two static questions related to the bank that you are supposed to tell me in the comment section below. Okay. So this question is very important because it is about the first payment bank in India. So let's discuss what this entire question is. Which has become the first payment bank in India to offer multi-partner FD service to its account holders? Okay, so I think that many of you have got confused. So wait a while. Let's answer this question, and then what this multi-partner FD service is, I will be discussing that. So we have Airtel Payments Bank, Jio, Finno, Paytm, India Post Payment Bank. Out of these five options, the right answer is option D. It's the Paytm Payments Bank. Now, Paytm Bank has recently partnered with Suryoday Small Finance Bank to offer the FD services to its account holders. And similar kind of partnership was already there with the IndusInd Bank. So recently, these two organizations have partnered to offer the FD services. Now, what is this multi-partner FD services? Let's take the example of this case only. Paytm is the host, Paytm is the account holder bank, account holding bank. Now the customers of Paytm will get the option to have their FD accounts either in Paytm or in Suryoday or in IndusInd Bank. So they will get the option to open their FD account in each of the bank according to the competitiveness of the FD rates or tenure. So now the customers are getting the option to choose from the offers that are being provided to the customers by these banks. So the Paytm Bank account holders can now open their FD accounts at Suryoday Small Finance Bank, or if they wish, then they can also open their FD account in the IndusInd Bank by being the customer of the Paytm Payments Bank. So this is the multi-partner. Multi-partner means more than one partner. So it has more than one partner. Earlier it was only IndusInd Bank, but now Paytm has also partnered with Suryoday Small Finance Bank. So multi-partner is this, and FD fixed deposit service. So that by virtue of this association, now the customers, now the account holders of Paytm can get their hands on the FD rates at Suryoday as well as on IndusInd Bank. So that is the whole meaning of this multi-partner FD service. Now I hope that this question is clear to you. Now I expect a question from you, and the question is: the MD and CEO of Paytm Partners, Paytm Payments Bank. Next is, who has won the Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award for his dedication to the service of humanity? So you can read the options on your own. Let me tell you that the person who has got this award is not of any great stature. He is the chief of an regional traffic office in Thane, Maharashtra. So he has got this Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award. So this is a good initiative that people at the low stature are also getting recognized for their services. Now let's discuss the answer of this question. What is the name of that person that has got this award? It is Ravi Gayakwad. Remember, he is the chief of this RTO Thane. Because however, the chances are meager, but there can be a question on this as well. So remember this. Next question is, who is the author of a textbook of urban planning and geography book? So again, you have the options, read them out on your own. And in the meantime, let me tell you that this book is important because the Vice President of India, M. Venkaiah Naidu, has released this book. So because of this fact only, this book becomes important. Now tell me, who is the which one has written this book? The right answer is option B. Sameer Sharma is the author of this book. Next is, how many countries are members of World Health Organization? Now, from where does this question come up? The reason behind this question, that I put this question in the current affairs video, is that recently United States has rejoined the World Health Organization on the mandate of US President Joe Biden. Now guys, can you tell me that he is the president of which number? Okay, let me tell you that he is the 46th president of US. Joe Biden. So on Joe Biden's mandate, United States has again joined World Health Organization. Now, how many countries are now the members of this organization? So the right answer is 194. Okay, World Health Organization members are there. And the headquarters is in Geneva, Switzerland. But who is the director general? That question I'm reserving for you guys. Tell me the answer in the comment section below. Okay, yes, we have talked about the president. Then I expect you guys to know that who is the first president in American history to get impeached twice. So what is the answer of this question? It's Donald Trump. So who can be the other man? It's the Donald Trump that has become the first American president to get impeached two times. That's the minor fact that I expect you guys to remember. Okay. Where is the Gorewada International Zoo located? So, why is it in news? The reason behind this is, it has been recently renamed. And what is the new name? That I will tell you after telling you the location. So, it is located in Nagpur. And the new name is Balasaheb Thakre Gorewada International Zoological Park. So Balasaheb Thakre has been added in front of this name, and this zoo has become Zoological Park. So that's the minor change that has been done in its name. Now you have to remember the place where this is located as well as the new name. And that's all for this session. I hope that you have liked it and enjoyed the session. And if you have, then do like it and share it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching the video.